studies. I believe you all are studying well. What did we learn in the previous class? Do you remember? Okay, then let's revise. A king who believed that he would not fail if he knew the answers of three questions. Many wise men came, but their answers were all different. None of the answers satisfied the king, so he decided to meet a hermit. Okay, then let's continue our class.
As the king came near the hermit's hut, he saw the hermit digging the ground in front of his hut. He greeted the king and continued digging. The hermit was old and weak, and as he worked, he breathed heavily. The king went up to the hermit and said, "I have come to you, wise hermit, to ask you to answer three questions. How can I learn to do the right thing at the right time? Who are the people I need most? And what affairs are the most important?" The hermit listened to the king but did not speak. He went on digging. "You are tired," said the king. "Let me take the spade and work in your place." "Thanks," said the hermit, giving the king his spade. Then he sat down on the ground. The hermit was an old man and was busy digging the ground in front of his hut. The king told the hermit that he has come in search of answers for his three questions. The hermit listened to the king but did not respond and continued digging the ground. Some time passed and the king, seeing the hermit to be tired, so he offered his help. The king took the spade from the hermit and began to work in his place. When the king had dug two beds, he stopped and repeated his questions. The hermit gave no answer, but stood up, stretching out his hand for the spade and said, "Now you rest and let me work." But the king did not give him the spade and continued to dig. While doing the work, the king kept on asking the three questions, but the hermit also kept silent. The hermit stood up and asked for the spade, but the king did not give him the spade. 1 hour passed, then another. The sun went down behind the trees, and at last the king stuck the spade into the ground and said, "I came to you, wise man, for an answer to my questions. If you can give me no answer, tell me so and I will return home." "Here comes someone running," said the hermit. The king continued digging the ground till evening. In the evening, the king again requested the hermit to answer his questions. But at that moment, someone came running towards the hermit's hut. The king turned round and saw a bearded man running towards them. His hands were pressed against his stomach, from which blood was flowing. When he reached the king, he fainted and fell to the ground. The king and the hermit removed the man's clothing and found a large wound in his stomach. The king washed and covered it with his handkerchief, but the blood would not stop flowing. The king redressed the wound until at last the bleeding stopped. The king saw a man running towards them with a hand on his wounded stomach. He was badly wounded and dying. They removed the clothing of the man and found that a large wound in his stomach. So the king washed the wound and bandaged till the blood ceased. The man felt better and asked for something to drink. The king brought fresh water and gave it to him. By this time, the sun had set and the air was cool. The king, with the hermit's help, carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. The man closed his eyes and lay quiet. The king, tired by his work and the work he had done, lay down on the floor and slept through the night. When he awoke, it was several minutes before he would remember where he was or who the strange bearded man lying on the bed was. "Forgive me," said the bearded man in a weak voice when he saw that the king was awake. The man felt better and asked for some water. The king gave fresh water to him. The king and the hermit took the man inside the house. The man was lying quiet inside the house and the tired king too fell asleep on the ground. When the king woke up in the morning, he saw the man was looking at him and asking for forgiveness. "I do not know you and have nothing to forgive you for," said the king. "You do not know me, but I know you. I am that enemy of yours who sought revenge on you because you put my brother to death and seized my property. I knew you had gone alone to see that hermit and I made up my mind to kill you on your way home. But the day passed and you did not return. So I left my hiding place and I came upon your bodyguard who recognized me and wounded me. I escaped from him, but I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds. I wished to kill you and you have saved my life. Now, if I live, I will serve you as your most faithful servant and will order my sons to do the same. Forgive me." The king wondered that what had happened. The man told the king that he had come to take revenge on him because the king had killed his brother and had taken away all his property. So he wanted to kill the king while returning from the hermit's place. But the king's bodyguards found him and wounded him. He would have died if the king would not help him. He regretted his thoughts of killing the king and promised to be his faithful servant. The king was very happy to have made peace with his enemy so easily and to have won him over as a friend. He not only forgave him but said he would send his servants and his own doctor to look after him, and he promised to give back the man his property. The king was pleased to turn his enemy into a friend. He forgave him and returned all his property. Thank you. I will be back with more about the king and the hermit.